move now to Tanzania. An official Irish government delegation is visiting several countries in Africa to see at first hand the impact of Ireland's development program and explore ways that Ireland can assist African partners to grow their economies. The aim is to exit from aid dependency and develop stronger trade relations between Africa and Ireland. Joining us now on the line from Tanzania is Irish Minister for Foreign Affairs and Trade, Joe Costello. Mr. Costello, thank you so much for joining us here on Beyond Markets. Of course, you kick off your visit to the continent with stepping into Tanzania. Take us through some of the key aid projects that Ireland is involved in Tanzania, and have you been able to assess the efficacy of those initiatives in the country?
Yes, indeed. Thank you very much. Good afternoon. I have been here in Tanzania now for nearly 5 days, and I've had the opportunity of going to quite a number of Irish projects, particularly in the area of education, in the area of health, to primary schools, to third level institutions. I have seen quite a lot of activity in terms of infant mortality and the work that has been done in health centres that are funded by Ireland to a large degree. I've had an opportunity of seeing the rural electrification that has taken place, where there is a strong Irish involvement in it. I've seen water irrigation, water schemes, where the rice product has increased to sixfold, which has been enormously beneficial to the people concerned, and where funding can be put into education, the surplus funding that becomes available. So it's an opportunity that I've had, and that I was very important. I was very concerned that I would be able to come and go out into the fields, into the villages, talk to the ordinary people, particularly to small farmers, see the problems that they experience, see whether or not they are getting worthwhile benefits from the funding that has been prepared. And Ireland is very anxious to ensure that we work closely with the authorities, with the local authority, with the regional authority, with the national authority to maximise the use of the funding that we make available. And I had an opportunity of doing that, and subsequently had an opportunity then of going and speaking to relevant ministers, to speaking to parliamentarians, and indeed just this morning I've been speaking to your Prime Minister and the Controller and Auditor General in relation to his assessment of how the various public funds are being used. So it was a very worthwhile number of days that I've had here in Tanzania.
Now, of course, as part of Ireland's EU presidency, you will also be chairing the EU Southern African Development Community political dialogue in Mozambique, and you'll be coming to South Africa as well. Take us through how Ireland views Africa as an investment destination, particularly against the backdrop of the crisis in the Eurozone and the fact that Europe has been going through a very tough time economically. Are you looking to strengthen trade ties, and what are the kinds of opportunities that you see in Africa given the fact that the euro isn't doing, or the rather that there are problems in the eurozone?
Yes, Ireland has the presidency of the European Union at the present time, and we are very anxious to emphasize the importance of development, of growth, of employment, because for quite a number of years now the European Union has been pretty stagnant in terms of economic growth, while there has been enormous economic growth going on in Asia and particularly in Africa. So we are beginning to stimulate during our presidency the employment and the growth side of the economy in the European Union. We are very anxious that the relationship between Africa and the European Union should develop under our presidency as well. And one of the things that I will be doing, as you mentioned, is chairing the SADC meeting between the European Union and the SADC countries, and we will be exploring various areas from political matters that concern the various countries to economic matters, and we are anxious to progress insofar as possible the economic partnership agreements that have been long outstanding, that have been sitting there since the year 2000. But we're anxious to progress those agreements with various African countries, particularly the SADC countries, so that they would be beneficial in relation to trade, in relation to investment, in relation to employment, and for Africa. And we're because there are bottlenecks and there are difficulties, and where there are areas that African countries' interests need to be protected, we'd be very flexible and sympathetic and sensitive to those needs. So it's not a question of forcing any country into an agreement, it's a question of seeking to make progress for the mutual economic benefit of all our countries. So I'm looking forward to a very fruitful relationship over the next couple of days here in Africa, and as you mentioned also, as well as going to Mozambique for the SADC European Union summit, I will be going to South Africa, and South Africa is
indeed. Mr. Costello, thank you so much. Of course, we have to leave it there. That was, of course, Joe Costello, who begins his visit to Africa with a stopover in Tanzania.